Okay, what's up, mga ka-investa? And in this video, I'm gonna be talking about how to take profits. Kasi pa lang, sisimula pa lang tayo sa market, pag newbie, minsan wala pa, yung una natin na tututunan is how to cut losses, diba? Kasi nagkakapapa tayo sa strategy. But eventually, ako naranasan ko to. Nung nakuha ko na yung strategy na gusto ko gawin, tapos bigla ako nagka-profit, parang nagulat ako kasi first time ko lang magka-gain kasi poor losses nung una, di ko alam paano magbenta. So I'm gonna show you guys 4 ways on how you can take your profits, diba, systematically, hindi lang yung bigla ka magbebenta. So the first way is a way na I'm sure most of us already know is pag-set ng TP or target profit. I'll go straight na to examples, ano. So one way to take profits is to set a price kung saan mo gusto magbenta. And usually, what you do is you set yung presyo ay yung TP mo sa mga dating resistance levels. So let's say for example, itong si green. Well, let's say dito, ito yung resistance, tapos bumili ka sa breakout, kunyari, dito sa box na to, di ba? Nagyan tayo ng box dyan, yan. Let's say bumili ka dyan sa box, nag-accumulate ka. Tapos, the next day, itong day na to, grabe yung breakout, no? So, from the previous candle, umangat siya as high as, halos nag-ceiling, di ba? In one day, 50% up ka na. So, paano mag-take profit sa ganito pag TP sa set mo? So, one thing you can do is you can take a look at a longer term time frame. Kasi, pag nag-scroll back ka, di mo alam saan yung dating resistance eh. So, pwede mo tingnan yung monthly chart. Tapos, tignan mo, okay, saan ba yung next na resistance kapag ganyan? So, as you can see dito, yan yung next na resistance sa longer term time frame, itong area na to, yung 350 area. Tapos, pag bumalik ka actually, ito, grabe, sobrang sakto. Pag bumalik ka, sakto, dun talaga nauntog si green. So, that's one way to set target profits is to take a look at the longer time frame and look for longer term resistances. Pero, pwede rin naman, di mo naman kailangan lagi pumunta sa longer term time frame. Pwede namang yung dating resistance last month, yun yung i-use mo as yung target profit mo. So, let's use ASX as an example. Ito, nag all-time high ata to dito eh. Tapos nag-fade, di ba? Tapos bumawi. Tapos eventually, dun din nauntog. Diba? So, let's say, nakabili ka sa MA50. Let's say, genius, no? Nakabili dito sa bounce sa MA50. Saan ka pwede magbenta? So, pwede ka magbenta sa previous resistance. So, dun. Tapos up, tapos 73% na yung upside mo dun for ASX. So, that's one way to do it. And another way naman, you can do both naman actually. Pwedeng i-set mo yung tawag dito. Pwedeng dalawang take profit pala. So hindi naman necessarily need na sa isang area ka lang maglagay ng TP, pwede dalawa. Pwede ka mag-sell half, tapos sell half ulit. So gamit natin si HPH as an example. Punta tayo sa longer term time frame ulit. So pagtignan natin, yung major resistance niya, itong 3 pesos, di ba? Ito yung all-time high level niya. Whoops. Ayaw. Yun. Tapos yung next na nun, yung before that, would be somewhere dito sa may 217 area. Yan yung maraming wick. So assuming na di pa umabot si HPH sa presyo na yan, no? Assuming na nandito pa lang tayo, kunyari. Let's say yan, bumili tayo sa breakout na to. So 170. So ngayon, saan ka magti-TP? So yun, check mo lang yung longer term time frame. So kita natin na dyan sa 217 area, mukhang maraming resistances, pati sa 3 pesos. Balik tayo sa daily. Yun, dyan ka na magti-take profit. So first sell mo dito banda, 55%. Tapos yung second benta mo naman, dito na banda yan sa 3 pesos, sakto. So that's one way to take profits. Pero one thing na I learned, there's nothing wrong with setting TPs, no? Everyone does it, I still do it till this day. Pero sina Minervini, Mark Ritchie, mga momentum masters, actually sila, hindi sila nagsiset ng target profit. So tataka ako bakit, yung reasoning nila is, you're limiting the upside, yun yung sabi nila, you're not letting the stock go as high as it can possibly go. Diba? So gusto nila parang, hindi sila magset target profit, they'll let it go as high as it wants to go. But what they usually do is they either sell into strength or sell into weakness. So ito yan, yung second and third. Selling into strength and selling into weakness. So right now, papag-usapan ko yung selling into strength. So basically, pag umaakit kasi yung stock, ng ganyan. Diba? Grabe si Nickel, no? Ano ba ibig sabihin yan? Malakas, diba? So, may strength yung stock kasi maraming demand. And syempre, mas madali magbenta habang yung stock paakyat. Diba? Kasi binibili siya, eh. So, pag nagbenta ka, okay lang, mabilis na. Tama mo yung bid, tas aangat pa minsan. Pero, mas mahirap magbenta kapag binubuhusan na. Diba? Pag grabe na lahat nagbebenta, ang hirap na magbenta. Diba? Like, let's say yung bid na sa 470 pesos, tatama mo 470, hindi ka ma-feel kasi nag-450 na. So, ito yung nasa-solve ng selling into strength. Especially kapag, let's say, malaki yung account mo, lalo na sa PSE, mahirap magbenta kung walang demand, eh. So, selling into strength is basically selling when it's easy to sell. Kasi mahirap mag-sell kapag yung buhusan na. Let's take now na lang yung una natin example. Yung itong day na to, yan, mahirap magbenta dyan, eh. Napaka-volatile, oh. Umabot ng 20, tapos umabot ng close to 9 pesos ulit. Hirap magbenta sa ganyan. So, one thing you can do is you can sell into strength. So, let's say, for example, dito ka bumili. Yan, may resistance dyan, diba? Bumili ka sa breakout. What you can do is when you see na yung ganyan, yung grabe na yung inangat in a short period of time, that's what you call, and nagbenta ka dyan, that's what you call selling into strength. Selling kapag lahat ng tao optimistic, selling kapag malakas yung stock. Hindi mo inaantay na mag-breakdown pa. But as ito, medyo subjective siya when you want to sell into strength. Usually, you want to sell into strength kapag yan, may malaking spike na ganyan, or dito, pag mabenta mo sa may mga 18 pesos, para maiwasan mo yung ganito na buhos. Grabe, ang hirap kasi magbenta pag ganyan, eh. And going back to nickel, diba, so may console pattern, buy on breakout, diba, pwede ka nga magbenta dito sa day na to, eh. Pag nakabili ka sa below 280, let's say dito, up ka na 50-60% in one day or 2 days, pwede ka na magbenta dyan, eh. Or dito, dyan sa area na yan, habang madali pa magbenta, habang yung mga tao gusto pa yung stock na to, that's selling into strength. Diba, another example, let's say ito si food. Diba, nung time na to, yan. So from yung pinaka low area niya, let's say nag-accumulate ka dyan. Diba? Umangat siya 115% in a few weeks. So pwede ka magbenta ka dito pa lang sa initial spike or dito habang madali pa. Kasi mahirap magbenta dito sa, you know, yung down siya ng ganyan. Bubaba siya ng 17%. Mahirap magbenta sa ganun. So that's selling into strength. Selling habang madali pa and habang paakyat pa yung stock. Now, but another thing you can do, of course, but the problem with selling into strength pala is minsan maaga ka mapapabenta talaga. Say for example, pag si Haven na trade mo, let's say nag-sell ka into strength from 20 pesos kasi umangat to ganyan, oh, say nagbenta ka sa 100, solid na yun, diba? From 20 to 100 up ka 300-400%, so yung pala umangat pa, diba? Umangat 1000 plus whatever percent, diba? So ngayon, that's the downside to selling into strength. Usually, you'll sell too early. So, what you can do is you can sell into weakness. And ito basically yung sinasabi na gumamit ng trail stops. So, trail stops can be whatever indicator you want, pero mostly, it's the use of moving averages. So, magsasell ka lang kapag yung price nag-close below yung moving average na gusto mo. So, it's basically trend following, kumbaga. So, some examples of this, let's say, si SLI. Diba? Gamitin natin si MA50. Let's say, bumili ka dito sa breakout na to. Yan, dito. Diba, sa area na yan. Nung ganyan pa yung itsura. So, magsasell ka lang at a profit kapag yung stock nag-close below MA50. So, as you can see, never siya nag-close below MA50 hanggang sa nag-dito. Yan, sa may 260 na area. So, up ka niyan, 72%. So, the reason why some people want to sell into weakness or use trail stops is in order to take advantage of potential big trends. Kasi kapag mag-sell ka into strength, minsan dito pa lang, baka mapabenta ka na, eh. Diba? Up ka na in a week or two ng 20%, 23%, solid na yun. But if you really want to take advantage of the big moves, sell into weakness ka, trail stops gamitin mo. Another example would be Wilcon. Diba, nung time na to, ito all-time high siya dito. Yan sa area na yan. Sa breakout or let's say nag-buy ka support. Sell on a close below MA50 dito na yun. Yan, sa may 17 pesos. Of course, kapag trail stops ginamit mo, never ka makakabenta sa tuktok. Diba? Mas mahirap yun. I mean, hindi talaga kaya kapag trail stops or selling to weakness yung style mo. So yung mangyayari is, you're gonna give away a little open profits talaga, but by giving the stock more room to fluctuate, potentially, makasakay ka talaga sa big trends. Kasi ito, maraming mga pullbacks to eh. Pero kung stick ka lang sa trail stock mo, mahahawakan mo yun. So last example would be si Tubbs noong 2017 dito. Yan, so let's say dito ka bumili. Say dito ka bumili. Again, kapag selling to strength yung style mo, which is nothing wrong with that naman. Kasi dito, let's say boom, up ka na 45% in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 days. Solid na yun, walang problema dun. But if you sell into weakness, di ba, of course, you're going to have to go, titiisin mo to, medyo yung down ka 20%, ay yung open profits mo nawala. Pero you can take advantage of a potential big move or a big trend. Diba? So kung sinundan mo lang yung basic na MA50 trail, up ka 92%. So, but of course, walang hard and fast rules, no, na dapat selling to weakness ka lang or selling to strength or target profit ka lang. You can do a combination. Diba? Yung fourth style is doing a combination of all three or two. Say, let's, ano kaya maganda example? Let's say si House. Ito, personal example ko. So si House, dito, ang ganda ng konso pattern niya dito, no? Nag 52 week high siya dito, tapos nagsabi ko, antayin ko mag-consolidate, di ba? Para may low risk entry tayo. So bumili ako dito, nung sa open pa lang, nag-gap up sa 880, bumili na ako, tapos nag-add ulit ako sa 9. Nasabi ko, sige, I'll trail MA50. Diba? So nung dito, sa area na to, sabi ko, grabe na yung inangat niya. Tingnan mo naman yung angle niya, parang 90 degrees or something. Tapos umangat na siya, 40%? So kumita ako 40% in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Mga 2 weeks, di ba? So okay na yun. So ginawa ko, nag-sell ako na half. So this is the art of selling half. When you sell half, and nagbenta ka, tapos bumagsak, you can say na parang, oh, buti nila nagbenta ako ng kalahati. Tapos kapag nag-sell ka na half, umangat pa, pwede mo sabihin, oh, buti nag-keep ako ng half. So parang win-win psychological trick yun. Nag-sell ako half, sabi ko, trail ko yung rest MA50. Tapos biglang wala, nag-trend lang siya. Tapos maraming continuation patterns. Kaya medyo paborito ko example to eh. Kasi sobrang textbook sa tinuro ni Minervini. So yan, nag-support pa siya dito. Diba? So benta ka lang kapag nag-close below. Which is nangyayari dito yan. Dito sa area na to. So sa 50% ng position mo, nakapagbenta ako, ay ako pa, kayo, let's say 42%. Then yung rest, hold mo lang hanggang nag-close below MA50. So additional 30% upside pa yun. So yun yung combination, di ba? Another example, let's say si Pip dati. Dati monster trend to eh. Sana ba yun? Lala ko sa vlog ni Imbang Klase eh. Meron siya neto ng time na to eh. Ayun no? Grabe. So pag combination ginawa mo, oh grabe no? All time high breakout. Yung nangyari dito. Oops, dito na lang. Yun o. All-time high breakout dito, nag-continuation pattern pa. So kung all-time high kasi, parang unlimited upside na yan eh. So let's say, nag-sell ka into strength dito. Kasi grabe na nga to, multiple candles, green, 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 green. Diba? So pwede ka magbenta ng onti dyan. Hindi naman kailangan lahat. Pwede 30%, pwede 50% ng position. So 60% upside na yun. Then in the rest, trail mo ulit MA50, MA20, kung ano gusto mong trail stop. Tapos yan, dito ka mapapabenta sa 640. So total na kinita mo yan, 57% to 75%. So last example, let's give an example noong 2019. Si GSMI. Again, same thing, you can sell into strength, tapos you can sell next into weakness, di ba? So dito, nagka-breakout. Boom. So yung kung ako to, di ko to na-trade personally, pero feeling ko lang mapapabenta ako dito bago mag 60 pesos. So yan, pwede ka mag-sell into strength habang madali pa, habang optimistic pa yung mga tao, benta ka na konti. Tapos trail mo na lang, MA50 or pwede yung gusto mo, mas tight MA20. Kung MA20 naman, mapapabenta ka na dito. So halos same lang sa first sell mo, di ba? Pero at least, you gave it an opportunity for a bigger move, which nangyari nga. So let's say MA50 ginamit mo. Mas pangat mga benta mo, pero yun. So that's basically it. You can do a combination of both. So guys, what's important na talaga? So I gave you guys some tips, diba, on how you can take profits. What's important na talaga is knowing na you can't, it's super hard to sell the top consistently. Maraming tao kasi parang binibeat down yung sarili. Hindi na benta sa tuktok, diba? Or napaaga yung benta. Pero two things talaga will happen lagi. It's either you're going to sell too early because you're selling into strength or dahil nag-target profit ka, or you're gonna sell too late kasi nag-sell into weakness ka, nag-trail stops ka, binigyan mo yung stock ng room to fluctuate. And may times talaga na mabibenta mo yung tuktok. Ako, nangyari na yun, nabenta ko yung tuktok, parang genius na, no? But of course, it's not something easy and medyo low probability na mangyari yun unless talagang genius ka or something. But for, you know, most of us, talagang mangyari is either magbibenta ka too early or too late. But what's important is, naman, is you make more than you lose, eh. Yun, you make more than you lose. Yung risk-reward trades that you take mo, solid. So, yun yung mahalaga. So, hopefully, nakaprovide ako ng value dito and magamit nyo to, mapractice nyo, mabacktest nyo, and makapag-sell tayo into profit together. So, yun lang guys. Hopefully, yan, nakaprovide ako value sa inyo and maraming salamat.